This is the story of how three dinosaur species became one dinosaur species. The three dinosaurs are called Pachycephalosaurus wyomingensis, Stygimoloch spinifer, and Dracorex hogwartsia.
They're popularly called dome-headed dinosaurs, or pachys, or pachycephalosaurs.
That's Mark Goodwin, a curator at the UC Museum of Paleontology. Mark has been doing fieldwork in Montana since the 1970s, along with his colleague Jack Horner from the Museum of the Rockies. For the past 12 summers, they've been working intently in the Hell Creek Formation. Their recent research is part of a multi-institutional effort led by Jack and called the Hell Creek Project. Their research has changed the way we look at these three dome-headed dinosaurs. The first fossil, now recognized as belonging to Pachycephalosaurus, was collected in the 1860s. The most recognizable and complete skull was discovered in 1940 in southeastern Montana. It was named Pachycephalosaurus grangeri by Barnum Brown and Eric Schlaker of the American Museum of Natural History. This dinosaur has a massive dome on top of its skull, clusters of pyramid-shaped bones on the front of its face, and rounded blunt squamosal nodes on the back of its head. Then, in 1973, a UCMP graduate student found a new fossil. It was missing its dome and had distinctive tall, pointy squamosal horns. It was pretty different from Pachycephalosaurus, and so, says Mark Goodwin,
they recognize it as a pachycephalosaur and being distinctive enough to give it its own genus, which was Stygimoloch.
The word Stygi comes from the river Styx, which in Greek mythology separates the earth from the underworld.
Because it was found in the Hell Creek Formation.
And the word Moloch means monster. So that's the story behind the name Stygimoloch.
A couple of years ago, Jack Horner called me and I got on the phone and he's like, he always goes, Mark, Jack, and it'll be a long pause. And he asked me this question about, he goes, he asked me what I thought about Stygimoloch. And I said, oh, well, we have a lot of them here and they have horns on the back of the skull. And he brought up the idea that it was in fact a subadult Pachycephalosaurus. I could understand that if you just had the frontal parietal dome that you would think it was a younger Pachycephalosaurus.
Because when you look at the front part of the skulls, the pattern of bony spikes, bumps, and nodes looks the same.
But I couldn't get my head wrapped around the idea about the spikes or the horns on the back, because the spikes on the back of a Pachycephalosaurus skull are smaller than what we see on Stygimoloch. So I said, well, you're telling me that the horns are large and then get smaller as the animal gets bigger. And he said, yeah.
Jack hypothesized that over the course of the dinosaur's lifetime, the horns reshaped themselves. This sounds a bit crazy, but Mark and Jack had seen it before in Triceratops. A type of bone called metaplastic bone can build itself up and break itself down or erode at different times in a dinosaur's life. And it can do this very rapidly.
And about this time, Dracorex was published by Robert Bacher as a new, yet another new pachycephalosaur from the Hell Creek Formation. He had a cool name, Dracorex hogwartsia. It was named after the Harry Potter series, and I had a lot of calls from reporters who sent me pictures of it, and I looked at it and I said, that looks like if I was going to have a candidate for a juvenile pachycephalosaurus, that would be it. And one of the reasons for this is when you look at the front end of Dracorex, Stygimoloch, and Pachycephalosaurus, and disregard the dome, which is an ontogenetic feature.
A feature that changes shape throughout an organism's development.
If you just look at the front of the skull, they're near identical, morphologically. And if you look at the back, you can see this transition that occurs with the size and shape of the horns. They don't actually get smaller, they just change shape. And we were able to demonstrate how they did that and describe this progression and take another look at Pachycephalosaurus and Stygimoloch and, of course, Dracorex. And we argue that they are, in fact, a growth series and represent one taxon, Pachycephalosaurus.
Mark and Jack used several lines of evidence. They looked at the histology, the microscopic structure of the horns and the dome. They found that the horns are made of metaplastic tissue, the tissue that can quickly build itself up and break itself down. The presence of metaplastic tissue provided a mechanism for the extreme change in shape of the horns over the course of the dinosaur's lifetime. They also looked at the histology of the domes. In Stygimoloch, the dome tissue was highly vascularized. It was getting lots of blood flow. This bone was growing quickly, Stygimoloch's dome was still inflating. In Pachycephalosaurus, the dome was made of denser tissue and was not as vascularized. Growth had likely slowed down. Mark and Jack used another line of evidence, computer tomography, or CT scans. They got a three-dimensional picture of the inside of the skulls.
And when we CT scanned Stygimoloch and we looked at the frontal bones, the intrafrontal suture is wide open.
Dinosaurs, just like humans, have skulls made of multiple pieces of bone. In juveniles, these bones are still growing, and at the margins, the places where the bones meet, the bones are not yet fused together. This is why, with human babies, you can feel a softer area on the top of their heads. That's cartilage, not bone. In both the Stygimoloch and Dracorex skulls, the margin between the frontal bones of the skull was still made of cartilage and not yet fused.
So that is evidence that this animal is still growing and that this animal is young.
All of this evidence led Mark and Jack to propose that Dracorex, Stygimoloch, and Pachycephalosaurus are not three separate dinosaur species. They are individuals of different ages of a single species.
And this is a real dinosaur extinction, if you will, because we've reduced by two-thirds the number of large domed pachycephalosaurs in the Hell Creek Formation.